Unity is the place where we can say, here and now, something is happening that is good, even when it hurts, even when it is painful, even when it creates anguish in us, but let's not run away from it.
When he was at Harvard teaching about Jesus to hundreds of people from all over, I was wondering if proclaiming the gospel to others wasn't the best way of losing your own face. A very ambitious institution, interested in the best and the brightest, in power and success, political influence and economic success, talking about Jesus wasn't only easy, but you found yourself pressured in adopting the model of the university. And I felt very lonely there. I couldn't pray very much. I couldn't make good friends. There was no much of a community. Everybody was competing. Everybody was trying to make it. And somehow, very deeply, I knew I had to do something, but I didn't know what. But finally, I came to visit Larsen Trulli and spent more time and decided Harvard wasn't the place for me, and but maybe I should look into Trulli and so on. And spent a year there, and finally the Daybreak community called me to come there as their priest. Well, that's the first movement from loneliness to Lash. But there's another one that's harder to talk about, but I still want to mention it to you because it's very important. When I was invited to come to Lash, the word most used is the word home. I come to offer a home for you. John said, maybe we can offer you a home. Our community likes to invite you to become the priest of Lash because we think that we can offer you a home. And that really spoke to me because my life was always alone. And in a competitive world of universities, that's the way it is. Community is not the word. Institution, yes. Competition, making it. But not community, togetherness, intimacy. And my heart was craving for some sense of belonging, some sense of home. So I came to Lash with that kind of desire.